We've been blaming the government a lot, but sometimes you find out that some of our relatives constitute the government. Somehow, people we see around contribute to the suffering of the rest of us in this country. We want to start from PSCN, formerly known as NEPA. For those of you who are not Nigerians, PSCN stands for Power Holding Company of Nigeria.
Those are the people that are holding our power and that have made us not to have light in this country.
Sorry about that. Don't mind Takpo. Like I was saying, then NEPA stands for National Electric Power Authority.
AKA, never expect power always. That one said was even better, because we used to have light, but not always. But now that they say they have done partial privatization and have changed it to power holding, they have decided to hold the power. We don't see it anymore.
You see, I want to use this PSCN to let us know how we have been inflicting ourselves with wickedness in this country. But we point out to the government, meaning the people in Aso Rock. Last December, I went to my sister's place in Abuja. I stayed there for about 5 days. My people, do you know that till I left that place, they never took the light once? And I began to wonder if it is the same Nigeria that we say there's no light. And to clear my doubt, I said maybe it's Christmas bonanza for the festive celebration. So I asked my sister, is this how you people normally have light? Guess what, Takpo?
I should guess?
Yes.
You are buying a toy gun tomorrow. Oh, okay. I know now. Uncle, you are applying for a job with NEPA tomorrow.
You are never serious. So, my people, back to our discussion. My sister told me that's how it has always been. They always have light uninterruptedly because they are using the same face with the international airport. And I began to wonder, really? So why don't we have light in some other parts of the country? Okay, this is what happens. After several years of studying these people and some reliable information I gathered, by the way, do you know that Nigeria supplies some neighboring African countries light? Let me not mention names. These countries have constant power supply, yet the supplier doesn't have light.
Me, I have never seen where a mother will cook food and give to the neighbors to eat and belly full, and her own children inside her own house will be hungry.
Exactly, Takpo. My people, that is the condition of our dear country when it comes to power. You give others and you don't have. So there's a certain reason why this happens. There's a whole corruption and scam practiced in PSCN, starting from the top to the bottom. Please listen carefully. I will start from the bottom. I have a friend who told me this story. He said he once worked as an attendant in a fuel station. So one day, their oga just drove in and asked, is this generator light or NEPA light?
For those of you that are watching from outside Africa, oga is Nigerian English, which means boss.
Yes. So the guy said he replied his boss that it was NEPA light they were using. The next thing, the man flared up. He said, what? Didn't I pay them? Why is there still light? Immediately, he brought out his phone and was making call as he walked into his office. This, my friend said, in less than 3 minutes, the light went off.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Hey, so they are so heartless that they collect money from one man and make others in the community to suffer for their selfish interests.
That is the corruption we are talking about. Another one happened in the environment where I'm living right now. I know a couple of people who have lived there before, whom, when you ask them the situation of light there back in the days, they will tell you there was always constant power supply. But that's where I'm living right now. As I'm speaking, we hardly have light. They give us when they like. Then I made my findings. Guess what? There's a filling station in the heart of the community. They said immediately that filling station was built and started operations, that's when they started having power issues. Till today, they've written several petitions to PSCN and got no tangible reply. Takpo, can you tie the knots?
The same thing you said that happened when the guy that the oga called NEPA to take the light so that they can sell fuel now.
Exactly. So some owners of filling stations pay NEPA to take the light so they can sell fuel. So you can see how people are so wicked. The owner of the filling station and the manager in NEPA office are just concerned about making money. They don't care whatever happens to the rest of the people. Let me give you another story. There's this friend of mine that is a dry cleaner. He said one evening one of his customers came to pick up his clothes. The guy was a Nepal official. Because he had so much to do that day, he was unable to finish ironing his clothes on time. So he was pressing this guy's clothes when they took the light all of a sudden. Guess what happened? He put a call through to his office and told his colleague to leave the light on, that he was pressing his clothes.
Hey, this is serious matter. So light has become their personal property that they can on and off to their own benefit.
Owori Takpo Amokinavu Apojovi. That is what most government officials do in this country. Your politicians think that they are the owners of Nigeria. They think you are just like a tenant in the landlord's house to them. The Nigerian government officials, especially politicians, don't know that they are called civil servants. English is not our thing, so they don't understand the meaning of the word servant.
Servants mean to serve someone now.
Very good, my dear. These people don't know that they are supposed to be doing what the masses want them to do. They think the opposite. The Nigerian government politicians believe that the citizens are the servants. They are the owners of the country. They don't know that all the money paid them and even the one they take by themselves belong to the citizens.
This is very bad, though. Uncle, how long is it going to take us to get out of this situation now?
I wish I have the answer to that. Another guy told me another story.
Hey, another one again.
Yes. This other guy told me that one day they were watching football in the evening. You know all those viewing centers that are also joints where people drink, so people come and sit down, buy a bottle of drink while they are watching football?
Yes. That after watching football, some people will start fighting each other to protest for a partiality that happened during the match. Club that don't know that these people exist though.
Yeah. So when the match was over, one of the guys told the other, Jeki Lok Paino. He was speaking Yoruba language, meaning let us go and turn off the light.
Put off which light?
He was a PSCN official, of course.
Oh.
Yes. So the guy and his colleague got on a bike and left. Minutes later, the light went off. It was at this time that the people who heard this guy made this comment now understood what he meant. So some minutes later, the guys came back to that place, probably to continue drinking since it was a joint. That was when one guy challenged them and almost beat them up.
If you check this guy that went to turn off the light, it's not as if they are very rich. So what do they benefit from turning off the light?
Probably that is the instruction that the boss must have given them. Or maybe that's how they've been told to regulate lights. Don't allow light to stay for too long. But why? Because some people somewhere are paying top NEPA officials to seize the light so they can do business.
Uncle, I was told that even people that are selling generators pay NEPA people to take the light too. And Nigeria is the highest importer of generator in the whole world.
I told you from the beginning that the whole NEPA system is corrupted from the bottom to top. The diesel and generator importers pay the bosses at the top. The filling station owners pay the regional managers. All to selfish interests. You think we don't have light in Nigeria? We can have 24 hours power supply. Didn't I start by telling the story of how I went to Abuja? Let me tell you something. If you live around area where there's this high tension power cable running through, then maybe you are the type that leave the home very early in the morning, like in Lagos where people go out early to prevent traffic. Sometimes you wake up in the morning going to work and there's no light. When you get to where these high tension power cables are, please stop and listen carefully. You hear a hissing sound from these cables. That is power traveling through the cables.
So there's always power, but some few individuals sit on it to make money, Abi.
Yes. Then there's another scam within the system, apart from taking the light and the bribery thing.
Which one is that one again now?
There's a way that they make it very difficult, especially in Lagos, for people to get the prepaid meter. This is so they can bring you a manual bill and manipulate it the way they like, because they know what they stand to benefit. When they bring you a bill of 5,000 naira, and you pay. The next time, they will increase it to 8,000 naira. If you pay that one, then the next one, they will increase it to 11,000 naira. And that is how it will keep going higher and higher and higher. That's what they do to people with no meter. Trust me, this money, not everything gets to the government account or to the main PSCN account. Why do you think they make it difficult for you to obtain a prepaid meter?
If you have a prepaid meter, they won't be able to cheat you again now. All those money that is going to the district managers won't get to them again because you'll be paying directly to the PSCN account.
Fantastic reply there. That is why Mita is difficult to get. Okay, let's look at it this way. Take a mobile network company for instance. Let's say Airtel now. Let's assume there's a way you can be using their service without a SIM card. So you'll be making calls and using data blindly without them knowing how much calls or data you are using. Then at the end of the month, the regional manager at your community or district will now give you a bill for a certain amount. And this bill is generated by this district head, not from the headquarters. Do you think Airtel as a company will grow or the whole money made from these bills will get to them?
No. People will be overusing the service now and they'll be paying less.
Thank you. That is why SIM card is almost free. They just want you to have it. Then they know once you have the SIM card, you will always buy credit so that you can make calls or use data. That is what the government should insist on. There shouldn't be any Nigerian using light without a meter. But since these people know they can scam you more when you don't have a meter, they will make it very hard for you to get. A colleague of mine once told me that where he's living was a two-bedroom apartment. Each month, NEPA will bring him a bill of 10 to 12,000 naira for energy consumption. Meanwhile, his friend that is living in a neighboring compound is living in a three-bedroom flat. Guess what? This guy has a prepaid meter and he's buying card of 10,000 naira once in every 3 months.
Uncle, are you serious?
Yes.
These NEPA people are thieves, so he's paying 3 times more than what someone with a larger house is paying.
You get the gist? I won't have another friend that they bring him a bill of 12,000 naira every month, yet he doesn't even see the light to use. This guy leaves home by 5 a.m. in the morning to go to work because he wants to avoid traffic. He comes back home by 9 p.m. or later. Guess what? He only uses a standing fan and 6 energy bulbs in the house. He has a TV, but he said he hardly turned it on because when he's back from work, he's tired. Weekend, they hardly give them light. Moreover, he spends time washing clothes and doing some other chores. So how then are they measuring the energy that this guy is using by bringing him that kind of bill?
Uncle, why can't they give the contract to a private organization to supply meter, even if you have to buy? Because even people that have money to buy it, they cannot get it.
It's the same reason we are talking about. They don't want you to have it.
It should have been like buying a mobile phone now. Then just like Glo and Etisalat like give people SIM card, NEPA can now connect you to be buying card to use power through the meter.
You see, even a small boy like this can think this way. Are you saying these people don't know things can be done this way? Assuming you are bringing the bill and people are having the light, it will have been a different thing entirely. We don't think of the negative effects of this act from a holistic viewpoint. Do you know how many organizations, industries and factories, including the ones owned by Nigerians, that have moved to neighboring African countries like Ghana and the rest of them just because of this power issue? Those are jobs that your fellow Nigerians will have had to make this country a better place and hasten development. Do you know how many small businesses that could not start because there is no money to buy a generator because they cannot rely on NEPA light to run? Do you know how many businesses that are folded up because of power failure? People have died in the hospital because there's no power to carry on surgery on them on time to save their lives. Some have died because you took the light and took their lives because they were on life support.
Even people that are jobless because of the companies that have moved to other countries and the ones that cannot afford generators or the ones that are folded up because of power failure like you said may end up in crime that will either end other people's lives or even end their own lives untimely now.
Exactly. So Mr. NEPA, Mr. Generator Importer, Mr. Filling Station Owner that bribes NEPA to take the light, you have blood in your hands. And don't forget to remember to remind yourself that you won't live forever.
He said you should not forget to remember to remind yourself that you will die one day.
Exactly. Like it or not, the negative impact you create on the whole lot of people, you will account for it. It's just that I don't want to mention all the things that power failure has caused. It's unfortunate. People have failed exam because there was no light for them to read. People have failed interview because they wore rumpled clothes. People have gotten robbed because there was no light. We can't name them all.
Uncle, how do we get out of this mess?
The only solution is when every home will start generating their own power to stop depending on these people. And from the information I've gathered, researches are going on for such power that will not be as expensive as the solar power that we have at the moment, that people can't afford. There's hope, my people.
But you people that are taking light or causing power failure, wash your hands so there is too much blood on it.
That is it. Thank you so much for watching today's episode. Please remember to subscribe and share this video, especially if you are new to this channel. We post every weekend, so subscribe and turn on the notification button.